for no other reason than I wanted to make the coolest vertical stream I could for myself, I decided to put a ton of effort into figuring out how to have my vertical scenes change on their own based on what was on screen at any given time. So if I'm just chatting with people, my vertical scene would just be my face and maybe the chat feed. Or if I launch a game and I'm in the lobby, it would be the game capture and my face cam, so I can still talk to people and they can still see me. Or if I load into a match in that game, it's just the game feed and nothing else. Some of these are easy to set up, and some of them are a little trickier and took a bit of time to get figured out and require more effort. So let's go over all of it, and you can decide for yourself if any or all of them seem like something you want to set up yourselves. For all of these, you will need Atom Vertical. So if you are not already using this plugin with OBS, you should be. Even if you aren't planning on multi-streaming to a vertical source or even putting out vertical content, you should definitely grab and set up this plugin for two big reasons. First, you aren't restricted to a vertical canvas layout, even though the plugin is called Vertical. You can switch it to landscape and run a second set of scenes and sources that are linked to or independent from your main setup. Which brings us to reason number two. This records independently from your main canvas. So if you were recording gameplay on your main canvas, you can record just your face capture through vertical and have clean outputs of both your gameplay and your face. Or using its independent backtrack, you can use vertical to record past segments of your content. Trust me, Atom Vertical will elevate the way you stream and make content. Use it. Okay, diving into the whole vertical scenes that make you say topic. For a few of the things I mentioned, all you really need is vertical installed and set up. Then you can create your canvases for basic scenarios, like if you are chatting or working on your desktop or watching a video with the chat. All you do for those is right click the scene inside a vertical and select linked scenes. Then find whatever scene you want to link it to from your main canvas and tick that box. So if you switch to your chatting scene on your main canvas, it will switch to your chatting scene on vertical as well. If you switch to your desktop, it will switch to your desktop in vertical. You get the picture. Any linked scenes will change together, whether you set up hotkeys, toggle the scene change using your voice and StreamerBot, or press a button on Touch Portal or Stream Deck if, you know, you think that's worth it. Shout out to Touch Portal for being the real ones. Love you. Okay, now for the really real stuff that is going to take this to a whole other level. Subscribe for part two. Nah, I'm just kidding. I wouldn't do that. I should though. Okay, getting your vertical scenes to switch while you are in a game is a little bit trickier to set up, and you are going to need the Advanced Scene Switcher plugin to be able to see what is currently displayed on your screen and reactively switch your scenes based on that. To do this, you can either use a screenshot of the game or screen you want to trigger the scene change, which is pretty self-explanatory. You just take a screenshot of the screen, save it to a folder, and then load that in. Or my preferred choice is to use a specific area of the screen. And to do that, you will want whatever game you are setting up scenes from to be currently running. But I'm getting a little ahead of myself. Let's start with just how to set up ass. Yeah. Yeah. Sorry, I couldn't resist. Advanced Scene Switcher, ASS. Yeah, you get it. Click the link in the description below, which will bring you to the plugins download page. And on the right side of the screen, click download. Then choose the Windows Installer.exe. Once it is downloaded, and installed, open up OBS and click the Tools button at the top. You will now have the Advanced Scene Switcher option in that list. Click it to open the menu for it. And then on the left side of the menu, you have your macros box. Each macro is a set of parameters used to perform an action. So click the plus icon at the bottom to create a new macro and name it whatever you want. I don't know what you're going to be using this for or doing with it, so I can't tell you what to name it. Sorry. Once you have a macro created, over on the right side in the Edit Macro box, you have two sections. The top is where you will set up the conditions for it to act upon, and the bottom is the response it will execute when those conditions are met. Click the plus icon for the top box and change where it says Scene to Video. Change where it says OBS's main output to source. Select which source your gameplay comes through and change where it says exactly matches to matches pattern. Now, directly to the right is where you can browse for a screenshot if you choose to go that route. But if you scroll down, you will see a box that says perform check only in area. Tick that box and then click the button for show match, and it will bring up a live preview of what is coming through your source in OBS, which is why I said you need whatever game or program running while you do this. So with whatever game running, and after clicking that box, you can select an area of the screen you want Advanced Scene Switcher to recognize and use by simply dragging a box over the area in that preview, and then clicking the X at the top right to close it. Then after you have selected the area you want to use and closed that screen, scroll back up to the top and click the Browse button, and then click the button that says Create Screenshot, and save the screenshot of the area you just selected to your hard drive. After you have the area set, I would recommend ticking the Reduce CPU box and setting the check interval to the max. That should be everything you need to set the conditions, but you can also change the threshold, which is just like how confident it is in what it's seeing, I think. Don't take my word for it. That's just what I think it does. I could be setting that up completely wrong. I don't know. Whatever. Moving on. Now click the plus icon for the bottom box so you can set the response. Change where it says scene to hotkey. Then change the press to custom hotkey. Now you can select any hotkeys you wish, but I suggest using ones that would never be used by another program, like F13 through F24. I don't even have those on my keyboard, but they have them in here and in StreamerBot. So you can also select a modifier key. I myself like to use left control. So if you choose to, do it. Now follow these steps to create a second macro and set up a second scene in OBS Vertical. This way, when you get everything set up in StreamerBot, you will actually be able to see if your scenes are switching automatically the way that they should be. Cool? I trust you can handle that and set up a second scene on your own and a second macro without me repeating all of these steps again. Please. Don't make me repeat all of those steps again. Thank you. The StreamerBot end of things is pretty quick and easy. Create an action and name it whatever you want that makes sense given what your macros do. In the triggers box, set a hotkey trigger and make it the same as the trigger in the corresponding macro in Advanced Scene Switcher. So whatever hotkey you set up in your macro, that hotkey is the trigger you're gonna use here. Okay? Yeah? Cool. Then in the sub actions box, add an OBS raw sub action by right clicking, going to OBS and selecting raw. For the actual raw code, just copy the code from the description below and change the part that says change me to the name of the scene in vertical that you want this to change to. After that, you can duplicate this action and change the name to something that works for the second macro you set up. Change the hotkey to the second macro's hotkey, and then change the scene name in the raw to the second scene name in vertical. Now try changing the game screens between the two you have set up triggers for. So between the first macro's selected area and the second macro's selected area, and it should automatically change your scenes in vertical. And that's it. That's the whole setup. You are now completely done with this super cool automatic switching awesomeness, and you can go off into the world on your own and show them how totally cool you are. You're fantastic. I know that sounded sarcastic, but I mean it. You're great. You're wonderful. If you found this video helpful, and let's face it, you totally did, please click that like button. And if you're interested in even more awesome stuff like this for OBS, StreamerBot, and all things stream related, please click the subscribe button. If you have any questions about this or anything else, please leave a comment down below. Or if you would rather, you can pop into a live stream and ask there where I can answer directly. And in a lot of cases that require showing things in StreamerBot, I can walk you through it live. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a great day. And until next time, take care and stay safe.